What I hope to do in this video is look at this graph, y is equal to f of x, and think about the intervals where this graph is positive or negative, and then think about the intervals when this graph is increasing or decreasing. So first, let's just think about when is this function positive? Well, positive means that the value of the function is greater than 0. It means that the value of the function, this means that the function is sitting above the x-axis. So it's sitting above the x-axis in this place right over here that I am highlighting in yellow. And it is also sitting above the x-axis over here. And if we wanted to write those intervals mathematically, well, let's see, let's say that this point right over here is x equals a, let's say that this right over here is x equals b, and this right over here is x equals c, then it's positive as long as x is between a and b. At x equals a or at x equals b, the value of our function is 0, but it's positive when x is between a and b, or if x is greater than c. We could write it there, c is less than x, or we could write that x is greater than c. These are the intervals when our function is positive. Let me write this, f of x positive when x is in this interval or that interval. So when is f of x negative? Let me do another color. F of x is going to be negative. Well, it's going to be negative if x is less than a. So this is if x is less than a, or if x is between b and c, then we see that f of x is below the x-axis. F of x is down here. So this is where it's negative. So here, or x is between b or c. X is between b and c. And I'm not saying less than or equal to, because if at b or c, the value of the function, f of b is 0, f of c is 0. That's where we are actually intersecting the x-axis. So that was reasonably straightforward. Now let's ask ourselves a different question. When is the function increasing or decreasing? So when is f of x increasing? Well, increasing, one way to think about it is for every time that x is increasing, then y should be increasing. Or another way to think about it, you have a positive rate of change of y with respect to x. Or you could even think about it as, imagine if you had a tangent line at any of these points, the slope of that tangent line is going to be positive. But the easiest way for me to think about it is, as you increase x, you're going to be increasing y. So where is the function increasing? Well, I'm doing it in blue. So it's increasing right until we get to this point right over here, right until we get to that point over there. And then it starts decreasing until we get to this point right over here. And then it starts increasing again. It starts increasing again. So let me make some more labels here. So let's say that this is x equals d, and that this right over here, actually let me do that green color. So let's say this is x equals d. Now it's not a, d, b, but you get the picture. And let's say that this is x is equal to, let me do it a little bit, x is equal to e. So when is this function increasing? Well, it's increasing if x is less than d. And I'm not going to say less than or equal to, because right at x equals d, it looks like, just for that moment, the slope of the tangent line looks like it would be constant. We're going from increasing to decreasing. So right at d, we're neither increasing or decreasing. But then we're also increasing. So if x is less than d, or x is greater than e, or x is greater than e. And where is f of x decreasing? So f of x, let me do this in a different color. Let me pick a mauve. So f of x decreasing Well, it's going to be right over here. It's going to be right between d and e, between x equals d and x equals z, but not exactly at those points, because at both of those points, you're neither increasing nor decreasing. But you see right over here, as x increases, as you increase your x, what's happening to your y? If you go from this point and you increase your x, what happened to your y? Your y has decreased. You increase your x, your y has decreased. You increase your x, y has decreased. Increase x, y has decreased all the way until this point over here. So f of x is decreasing for x between d and e. So hopefully that gives you a sense of things. Notice these aren't the same intervals. That we are, the intervals where we're positive or negative don't perfectly coincide with when we are increasing or decreasing. So it's very important to think about these separately, even though they kind of sound the same.